Welcome to Alapal TV. This is episode 4, July 15th. Well, let's get right into what we've seen this week and what's coming up this weekend. Okay, let's start with Resident Evil Infinite Darkness. This is a CG horror series based on the popular Capcom video game series that has the voices of Leon Kennedy and Claire Redfield. It's animated. I was looking forward to this because I really like the Resident Evil world, I guess, and zombies are always a big thing with me. But sadly, I was kind of disappointed in this series. The story was just very predictable, I guess, and the CG animation just was nothing new. It really wasn't impressed with a lot of it, so I would say pass. The next one is Fear Street Part 2, 1978, which continues the trilogy. This is the second film in the Netflix trilogy. Takes place in Shadyside, 1978, and kind of continues the story, but also gives this backstory going back from 1978. The first part was in 1994, 98, something like that. And you get a little bit of that, and then you get the backstory to what happened to people before. So this is good. Not as good as part one, but I still enjoyed it, and I'm definitely going to see part three coming up. Okay, also this week, I watched A Private War on Netflix. It stars Rosamund Pike, who you probably remember from Gone Girl. She's a great actress. In this movie, she portrays a real-life person, and this is a real-life story, based on one of the most celebrated war correspondents, Marie Colvin. She is this utterly fearless and driven journalist who goes to the front lines of conflicts to tell the stories of people who don't have their stories told very often. So, good movie. On Amazon, I watched Flipped, which is a 10-year-old movie which takes the characters Bryce and Julie, who live across from each other in their neighborhood, and it's from grade school to like junior high. It's basically how their relationship and how they learn and grow together over a span of a few years. It's a good, nice, warming movie, and I would say definitely it's worth seeing. Over on HBO, I caught a new series called Jet. It covers a world-class thief called Daisy Jet Kowalski, who is played by Carla Gugino, who I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, but you've probably seen her in Watchmen, San Andreas, Sin City, Sucker Punch, just to name a few. She's been in a ton of films. She's always good. But basically, her character is ready to put her past behind her. But when she gets involved with a crime lord, she gets stuck in the situation, and now she's trying to figure her way out to free herself and her daughter from it. This is a really good series. I haven't finished it yet, but I'm like a good 6 or 7 episodes in. So definitely go over to HBO Max and check out Jet. Over on Hulu, I saw Lying and Stealing, which is a movie with Emily Ratajkowski and Theo James. Theo James plays a gifted and discerning art thief, so to speak, who is working his way out. He's basically paying off his late dad's debt to this crime boss. And Elise, Emily's character, is an aspiring actress who has her own past transgressions she's trying to get out of, or at least improve. And they kind of end up working together once they come across each other to help each other move on with their lives and together. It's a good film. I would say definitely go check it out. Okay, also on Hulu, I caught Bill and Ted Face the Music. It's the third in the trilogy of the Bill and Ted movies. In this one, the heroes attempt to create the song that will reunite everyone that's first mentioned in the first one. Man, this movie is a turd. It is horrible. Certainly not excellent. I would say big time pass. Really, really try to avoid this movie. I mean, I guess if you saw the other ones and really want to finish the series, go ahead, but I've warned you. Over on Disney Plus is the Loki finale. I've talked about this series a lot. I would say go check it out. just to be short. If you have Disney Plus, I would have thought you have. But so over on Disney Plus, of course, go check out the Loki finale and the series if you haven't started it yet. So this week I watched Physical on Apple TV. Now, I don't often talk about Apple TV because there simply just isn't a lot of content, but a lot of it is pretty good. Now, this series, Physical, stars Rose Byrne, who you've probably seen on Bridesmaids, X-Men First Class, Troy, Insidious. She's been out there, and you'll definitely recognize her. Very good actress. And basically, it takes place in 1981, and she's kind of stuck in this marriage, in this life, and she's trying to improve herself. She's got issues, but she finds an outlet in basically the aerobics field that's just starting to grow. So very good series. I haven't finished this one either, but I'm like 5 episodes into it and I've liked it very much. So go see that. So over on Netflix, we have Never Have I Ever seasons 2 starting this weekend. I really enjoyed the first season, so you wouldn't think an old guy like me would like that about a young Indian teenage girl going through high school and all the drama that ensues and family life. But I really did. It's pretty good. I'm looking forward to season 2. So also on Netflix is Deep. So also on Netflix is Deep, a sci-fi thriller where 4 med students get involved in a experiment that goes awry. So it looks interesting. So also on Netflix is Fear Street Part 3. Basically the trilogy ends where it begins in 1666, and we see what happened with Sarah Friar, and where she was burned at the stake and started the whole curse. So that starts this weekend. So again, on Netflix, we have a Bruce Willis sci-fi movie called Cosmic Sin, which by all accounts is probably pretty crappy. I might still check it out. Basically, he plays a general who comes out of retirement to help keep everyone alive and keep us from interstellar war with some aliens. So you've been warned. It may or may not be good. Probably not. Okay, lastly on Netflix is Gunpowder Milkshake. I'm really looking forward to this. This one looks like probably the most promising show for the next week. Check it out. It stars Karen Gillan as a young girl. Her mom's Lena Headey. She was an assassin. She gets raised by this assassin group. Has Michelle Yeoh. Tons of people. Paul Giamatti. It looks really good. I'm really looking forward to this. Angela Bassett. Can't say enough about it. Check this one out on Netflix. Okay, so over on Peacock is Dr. Death. And this is based on a true story of a doctor, surgeon, who basically probably through his own actions on purpose was killing people. So seems kind of dark and creepy, but it looks very interesting. So check that one out up on Peacock. Thanks for watching. That's it for Out of the Pal this week. Looking forward to seeing you next week. Don't forget to subscribe and feel free to leave a comment. Thanks.